After a rainstorm, have you ever noticed a stream or river that is brown and murky and wondered why? Rainwater or snowmelt is either absorbed by the ground or runs downhill off the land to a stream or lake. When rain falls or snow melts on impervious surfaces, such as paved roads, parking lots, and rooftops, or any surface that can't absorb water, it collects and carries with it sediment and other pollutants picked up along the way. This polluted stormwater runoff can cause brown and murky water in our streams and rivers. However, not all pollutants are as visible as sediment. Stormwater runoff can also pick up litter and other wastes such as pesticides, salt, oil, animal and pet waste, and nutrients found in soil and fertilizers, and carries these pollutants to our waterways. In cities, towns, and villages, stormwater runoff typically flows into storm drains in the street, then usually directly into rivers and lakes.
Well, we know that stormwater is a major problem and it's a contributor to increasing pollution levels in Lake Champlain and in other water bodies across the state.
There are many actions that you can do as a property owner to decrease the amount of stormwater runoff from your property and the pollution it carries and save you money. Here are four suggestions. 1. Get a soil test before using lawn fertilizers. You may need less fertilizer on your lawn than you think. 2. Mow grass to 3 inches or longer to slow stormwater so it will soak into the ground before becoming runoff. 3. Responsibly dispose of household products such as cleaners, paint, oil, and unused gas. And 4. Use green stormwater infrastructure practices such as rain barrels and rain gardens that soak up rainwater before it can flow off the land.
Using green infrastructure and infrastructure that implements a wide variety of natural processes can help to improve water quality in ways that gray infrastructure or the more conventional infrastructure that really just deals with volume can't address.
There are also actions that municipalities can take to better manage stormwater runoff. Many towns have teamed up with the Vermont Department of Environmental Conservation to map stormwater systems in order to identify stormwater contamination problems from leaking or incorrectly plumbed pipes. This includes contamination from sewage, laundry and sink water, or industrial waste.
We're looking for cross-connections between sewer and stormwater.
To identify these accidental connections, which can cause public health impacts if left undetected, water is tested to determine if and where a problem exists. Then, different tests are used to determine the exact source. Once the problem is found, replumbing can address it. This partnership between the state and communities improves local maintenance and development of town infrastructure. It also better prepares communities for environmental emergencies, such as an accidental spill of oil or chemicals.
What happens when an oil truck tips over? Nobody knows where the storm drains are, so it makes it a little more complicated in terms of keeping waste out of surface waters.
Visit our website to learn more about how you and your community can help take action to safeguard Vermont's streams, rivers, and lakes from stormwater pollution. Thank you for helping us protect clean water in Vermont.